Welcome back, everyone. Today on the workshop, we're going to be building up Revell USA's 69 Camaro SS396. It's got some new tooled parts underneath the hood. It's got a 2-in-1 option for the SS and RS builds. It's got 129 parts and comes out 7.437 inches long, which would make it 1/25th scale. Let's take a look inside the parts so we can see what we're going to be building with. First up, we got the nice clear tree, crystal clear, no distortion. We got our headlights, we got a nice reservoir tank, we've got fog lights and signals. Well done on those in clear, transparent red. We've got our taillight options. Always nice to have those done in transparent red. We've got some hubcaps on the chrome tree. Well done. Not too thick, still allows all the detail. We've got a set of four generic no-name tires. Performance tires with that tread on there. Flat, not the rounded over skinny tires. We've got a second chrome tree with our grill. Looks like the SS grill there with the slots out. Got our valve covers in chrome, air cleaner, bumpers, carburation, nice little door handles on there. Little bit. Small carburation, we've got our mirrors, rear view mirror, and those nice stock wheels. Check those out. Get up nice and close. All the small details you come to know and love from Revell. We've got a nice decal sheet on this one. We've even got the vents by the rear quarters, engine, SS emblems, 396 emblems, beautiful stripes in black and white, license plates, seat belts, and we can name the tires if we want as BF Goodrich radial TAs, full set of gauges, even the steering wheel horn cover. All great stuff that helps you super detail your model. On that sheet there, it's got a standard Revell manual, all black and white. It will call out what you need to use for the A and B options, depending on if you want to build it as the SS or RS. You can see right there, it'll let you know. So that's their standard black and white manual. We will switch to the other side of the table, start taking a look at the styrene, which is molded in white in this kit. Nice separate door panels. We've got a firewall with plenty of detail on it. Lower clip there. Rear suspension. Got under the hood. You can see the suspension there. Nice hood. I like for the inserts. On this one, we've got our 396 engine and transmission package, intake, water pump, steering wheel, air cleaner assembly. Nice exhaust. I like how these will pin together. I built this up as the 69 Yenko before. That's why I'm having fun with this one. You got our cylinder heads there. We got our steely wheel package with wheel backs. Nice detail on the wheels. Front suspension. A lot of you like the individual front suspension. I like when it's solid like this because I can still detail it, but it helps me set so I'd make sure that the car sits on all four tires. Got our shocks. Nice individual sway bar you could paint separately. Differential. Radiator. Dashboard. Highly detailed, especially with those decals, will go in there nicely. We've got a seat back here. There is another one, of course. That one just happened to fall off the tree. Got our chassis here. With this open tunnel means you'll have to paint the bottom of that interior tub. Fuel tank. Even got brake lines in there you can detail. Silver markers and silver pencils work really well to detail stuff like that. Got our suspension and engine cradle. Rear seat. Front bucket seats. And the top of that chassis so you can see inside the fenders. We've got the grill, full exhaust system, spoiler, rear pan, more wheel backs, distributor, master cylinder, starter, all the good parts for detail. Look at the instrumentation on the steering column, the stalks. Nice battery, master cylinder, booster pump, and then the nice 69 Camaro body, extremely iconic. Nice looking ride. The trim is nice and prominent. Like those vents back there for the quarters. Windshield wipers are molded in. Vents. Got that nice tough nose to it. All the way around to the back. Molded beautifully. Even got the lock molded in. Camaro emblems are molded in. So all you got to do is run your decal over that, some decal solvent. We'll see if we can get that to reflect. There we go. Door handles are molded in on this one, on the outside. And you got our Camaro logos, nice body panel lines like they should be. You could always deepen those with a scriber. So we are looking good. Great looking kit. I'm going to get to building my version and I'll be right back. Well, after working on the kit, I now know the first year that it came out, or at least a year that the molds are revised, on the very bottom here, in front of the fuel tank, where the trunk is underneath that differential there, it says 1990. It's got a copyright date, so it's modern-ish as far as, it's 30, oh my God, it's 32 years old? I grant, wow. 1990 was 32 years ago, people. Whoa, think about that one for a second. Anyways, while I'm having a little bit of a midlife crisis, that tells us that it is a more modern mold, and it does go together quite nicely. It's very easy to get to this point. We got a lot of stuff to paint, but it'll start going together quite easily, and it fits together nicely. We got the chassis here. I did glue the differential, the shocks, the springs, the front suspension, the sway bar, and the upper suspension arms all in as one. I can get that painted and individually detail it. We know that I love doing that. You can, of course, assemble these, this differential and stuff in place, and then remove it so you know what lines up and paint and detail that separately. The super detailers love doing that kind of stuff. I got the steering column all set up, ready to go, so that can get painted on its own. I like to glue those together. We've got our seats and our seat backs. I'm going to be doing those in a special interior color along with the door panels. But first, I will be priming everything in black that you see here and then doing our interior color, and I'll be removing the firewall and the lip spoiler, the lower lip there. I'll be removing those before I paint my interior because obviously I don't want to do the same color. I'm not doing a black interior on this one, but I will be primering it all black so we show a lot of detail before I get into the other stages. We got our interior tub. So we'll be getting primer on that, and don't forget to paint the bottom, because on this chassis, you will be able to see that transmission tunnel just fine when you place it on there. You can see how nicely that lines up. Make sure you paint that everything that you can see on there, or it will stand out quite a bit as white plastic from the bottom. The hood on its own is ready to go with the body. The body doesn't need any prep work or anything. I didn't even have to cut any nibs off of it. It just molded like that and it looks fine. The radiator, hood latch, horns, and surround are all one piece now and will be painted up. So that's a nice assembly there. We got our belt and pulley system. Alternator will be attached later. We got that Tree 96 right there for you. I put the distributor and the coil on it now so that I can get them attached solidly. Oil filter, fuel pump, water pump. I don't do the fuel pump in chrome. That's why I attached it. And our starter and solenoid. We can detail that after we get it all painted. I really enjoy hand painting my models instead of airbrushing or spraying things separately. That's just how I like to do it. We've got the rear pan here, which will fit in nicely. I know that it fits in nicely, so I can paint it separately. I did test fit the chassis into the body. We can do that again on camera. It is a tight fit, but it's a nice fit. Get that worked in there, but if you attach that rear piece, you might have a lot of problems, so I'm not going to put it in there. I don't want to have to cut it free later. Usually I can finagle it in, but in this case, those Camaro bodies kind of roll around in the back. But you can see the body is just flexible enough. There we go. Snap it in. Nice tight fit. We won't have to glue it or anything. And then we can get that rear pan in. When we do it up at the end, we'll be able to get it all together. So that's a nice fit in there. That will work out lovely. Got the exhaust and the brake booster. We can get those painted and do those in a metallic. We got the headers. They do look nicely. They are kind of gobbled at the ends because of the way the molds are. You know, they are 32 years old. So, I just blown up. 1990 was 32 years ago. So, we can fix that up when we paint it and stuff. Won't be a problem. And in the build I'm doing, it'll kind of go along with that story anyways. The dashboard's on its own little tree. The steelies are on their own little tree. We've got our stock wheels you could use. We got the RSS grill there with the cool little headlights and stuff that we'll be working on. So that's everything. I'm going to get everything over to paint right now, and I'll see you over there.
Thank you.
a second to last look at the Camaro SSRS before I seal it up and put everything together so you can see what's going on. I've got the interior done with our cracked white vinyl seats. They start to peel. They show some of the insulation. We got the extra hubcap on the seat there. We've got the dash done. We've got the dash stress cracked and worn through and everything on there. We got that interior a little dirtied up, so we are set to go with that. And that will push up inside the interior. It actually goes in quite easily. We can actually do it right on camera. A second here. All right, and then that little hole in the back will line up with the back of the interior, and then we'll hope everything goes in. The firewall will then insert and lock everything into place with a friction fit. So you can see how that fits in there. Now you can see how that fits into that body, which I really enjoy the work I've done on that. I apply the decals first, and then I take a little sandpaper to them and scratch them up. Then I did just a little bit of rust. This one I'm not crusting out. What I want this to be, my idea for this one is, it has been parked for a long time. It's faded. It's got a little bit of surface rust all the way around, just a little bit. But otherwise, this is a very fixable, restorable car. They started to take parts off of it. They started to take the spoiler off. They removed the carburetor on the chassis, hence why I painted it black and took the radiator hose off and then did the silver where there would have been a gasket there. They took one of the headers off, which I will include under the hood when we're all done, and I made sure to color those areas where the header was black. We got one header still on it. The valve covers are still on it. They haven't taken all that apart yet. The underneath, the exhaust has been unhooked because it's rotted. It's loose. It's not even on there straight or anything. We got one exhaust pipe lower than the other. It's all beat up. We're missing a hubcap, but they did find it, so they threw it on the passenger seat. And then we've got all the rest on there with the dirty, dusty tires and the Georgia clay, the red clay splattered up underneath, but the car isn't completely roached out, and it's definitely salvageable. We got some chrome rust and pitting on the bumpers and stuff like that, but again, this car is likely, put it back together, and you could probably drive it. That's the kind of look I'm going for. And that's all I have to do. I have to attach the spoiler in the front. We've got to attach the body, glue the bumpers on, throw that header underneath, and then the final part on the SSRS front end is what I hadn't put on yet, which was the SS emblems in the grill and on the rear, where I have a taillight missing and the bezel's kind of falling out on the other side. So that's what I wanted mine to look like. I'm going to push it together, which is all I should have to do. I'll let you know if I have any issues. I can tell you right away that these new hubcaps are a pain. They are, the way they are designed with the new style mold is, the release points are 4 points underneath. So even when you cut them out, it doesn't clean the inner trim ring, and you have to sort of balance it on top of the wheel with the glue. It doesn't sit over that ring. You have to, I put gel CA glue so I could balance it over the top. And then you can center them on there and let that glue dry, and they'll hold on to the centers. That's how you're going to get them on there. But that was the only thing. The tires fit a little loose around the wheels. It's a friction fit, but they do fit. Just be careful when you're doing final fitment. They might fall off. You just have to press them back in. It's a friction fit unless you wanted to glue those tires in place. Once I get the body on, we'll put our rear panel in, glue that in tight, glue the bumpers on, and we'll have that final reveal in just a moment. Welcome back for the final reveal on Revell USA's 69 Camaro SS396. It's a 2-in-1. It's got new parts in the box, so you can build the SSRS build option, which is what I did. But since I did this version of a Camaro, a 69, in a Yanko and made it all pristine, I thought, why not make it more of the super famous, everybody likes the barn find kind of stuff. Now, yes, the hood is sticking up a little bit. That's not a defect in the kit. And I know that the mega whiners online will claim I'm hiding something. So let's fix that right now. It's because I wanted that header to sit loose in my model, like they had pulled it apart. So we'll stick the hood back in. And look, it fits just fine. But I still know people are going to say stuff in the comments. Well, he's hiding stuff from us. I love those, that kind of stuff. So we'll put the header on the roof so we don't forget it for some pictures. But that's how it looks. It goes together beautifully. It fits nice. The chassis into the body, like I showed, is a very, very tight fit with the interior in there. It is a very tight fit. Make sure you get your interior tub pushed down all the way and everything smoothed out and your dashboard in the correct place, and then it will fit, but it's going to be tight. Same with the tires and the wheels fitting up inside. Very tight fit. The decals are so wonderful. I only allowed them to dry for like a half an hour, and I was able to held down so tight, I was able to start sanding on them and chipping them. The wing fits in nicely, so I drilled the holes, looked like they were kind of pulling the spoiler off, and they were messing with it back there. Roached out the interior, it's just crusted up vinyl, they can get the seats reupholstered, and mild surface rust, no intense rot or defects in the vehicle, and I sure liked building it. It all went together really cool. It's got that SSRS grill option for the front and the stock one, as you saw. Thanks to Revell USA for sending this over. Model Roundup has this on pre-order. Guys back there at Model Roundup, you can always get decals like that if you use code SWAGPACK and search on their website for it. You can buy the decal, the magnet, the button if they still have them in stock. When you order your 69 Camaro SS396, the old powerhouse. So I did some detailing under the hood after the final. You'll see it in the photos there. I added some oil, added some antifreeze underneath there as if they had started to pull things apart. And I hope, as always, that you enjoy the show. I do like your comments and everything down in the comments section. We will see all of you at the next review. And remember, what do I always say? When you get your kit, build for you. Rust it, crust it. Build it show perspective perfect. Build it Meekum auction perfection. Any way you want to go with it is what you should do, because it's your model. This is a hobby. Smile, have fun, and I'll see you next time.